And my daughter Jillian is here from New Hampshire, and she was gracious enough to say that she was saying, listen to the words and think about what they mean on a day like today. Let's just enjoy our time together. Thank you for starting us off. Thank you. So enjoy, please. Together. And it's funny because
and I've said it a hundred times, it's only fitting that this church is what it is. You walk into an airplane hangar and you look and you see a tent, and it's like, well, what are these people up to? But I'll tell you what, it's so much a picture of the people that come here. Glenn and Mari, thank you again so much for sharing. And I know you hate to be put on the spot. But he uses you mightily, so thank you. We're going to start singing this morning and just have some fun together. And again, think about the words we're about to sing. This is not necessarily a song you think about here in the church. But I tell you what, it's the kind of song I like to sing in church. Think about the words.
Wherever you go, I yell, I want to stop and thank you, Jesus. us that grew up in traditional churches, non-traditional. We're used to some hymns, and these songs are special, some of them, because they've been a part of our lives since we were little. And we don't do a lot of hymns anymore, and a lot of places don't because they're considered old-fashioned, outdated, whatever. But they're just too rich to let them go, so we're going to sing a hymn now that hopefully will mean something to you as well as it does to us. Thank you.
kids are gonna head out now, and I believe they have a little something special for you when you get out there, so everybody, all the kids can head back with Laurie. Head on out.
I'm not by myself, don't worry. I'm crazy, but not that crazy.
You got your eggs?
The other pot of coffee, though, I told somebody wants to grab a coffee.
And there's more coffee, if you want some coffee.
It's done now, so.
They left me more silverware, but I don't need it. Plenty of food. All right, as the kids head out, there usually is quite an event as the kids head out.
Come on, mommy's coming.
My grandbaby. As kids head out, you know, it's interesting, the things that we do to celebrate this thing we call Easter, right? The things that we do, like getting together, having a good breakfast, right? That's a good thing, we like that. Sending the kids off to do, which I'm sure they know, but that's, you know, that's where they're headed, they get to have some fun with that. But it's also interesting the things that we put ourselves through, true? Now, I don't know about you, but if we go back into the family album and we start to look at some of the things we did to make Easter special, you look at those old pictures and you cringe, right? And I've got a few that kind of bring to light that thing. So we're going to start showing those pictures one by one. How many people actually remember this, right? Gonna go see the Easter Bunny. The next thing you know, this massive person in a fuzzy suit comes at you, and you're horrified, right? So, next one. This is actually looks like natural skin on this animal, which is horrifying in and of itself. And these kids are like, no, they killed like 20 bunnies to make this suit. As we keep going. Who even sleeps after that? This kid's like, forget the basket. I love this one. It's like, candy doesn't matter. This thing's chasing me. Now, I know all of you have one of these pictures somewhere, right? Yeah? Mom went out and bought all the same material and said, I'm going to make everybody the same outfit, right? Now, I know we had something like that at one point, and I think I ended up with just the tie that matched everybody else, so I kind of got out of it easy, but you have these pictures in your closet, don't you? And this is almost just as horrifying as the dolls. Again, taking these photos. Now, photos are a great thing. They remind us of what has gone on in the past. We remember it. But in the process of photos, the poor kids, like, what is going on here? Now, this one's just... First of all, mom's got the perfect hair, right? Remember this back here? And then she's sitting there going like, yeah, like, this is what we do all the time. Yeah. This is the perfect family we are, right? I don't think so. So that one's awesome. You know who you are. I'm not even going to say it. You know who you are. And this is what it leaves us feeling like, right? Every one of us like, what is this all about? Really? And we might come back to some of these pictures later. I can put Joe on the spot maybe to do that. But it is amazing what we will do to bring things to focus so that we can remember them. Now, why do we go about these type of things? Why do we take holidays? Why do we take these times and try and make them special? Well, first of all, just as people, okay, we want to take and make certain things special and take certain times of the year and use them as like hallmarks in life, right? Because life goes by pretty quick. And so we take those times and say, let's slow down a little bit. Let's remember each other. Let's take the time to actually remember these opportunities. Now, when you start to think about times like this, the time of year certainly comes into play. Because what are we finally getting out of, especially here in New England? Winter. We're moving from winter, we're going into this new time of year where everything's going to be nice and it's going to be warm. And this winter wasn't that bad. Last year at this time, we were begging for this time of year, weren't we? It was crazy. And so we do take times like this, and we make sure that they're important to us. We make those hallmarks. We take times. But when I start to think about, you know, how we do that as a society, it's okay that we just kind of do whatever works for us. We have something that we kind of have in common, and we can celebrate it in that way that we all have the same idea what's going on. But then the family does what? They do the individual thing, like some of the pictures we saw. They do the individual thing to make it special to them, right? In my house, what we did was we cut out little bunny feet. And I would put the bunny feet down on the floor, and the girls would wake up and they'd see the bunny feet. Of course, they had to follow where the bunny feet went. And then there'd be a clue in whatever it was that it led to. If it was the bread box, they'd open it up and it would be some kind of clue that they had to figure out. There were a couple years where they were waiting for me to get up and say, "Dad, we have no idea where this stuff is." One of them was something, I said something about atomic, something atomic. And they didn't get it. Anybody, any guesses where it was?
In the hot sauce.
It was in the microwave. I mean, come on, it was, these little kids don't understand. So we do all these kind of special things, and in common, you know, as a culture, we say, yes, Easter's that time of year, and we're going to kind of have fun with the bunny and blah, blah, blah. But, and then we'll do special things in the family. But the question now becomes this. Why the bunny and the Easter eggs? What does a bunny and Easter eggs have to do? Like, bunnies don't lay eggs, right? Am I right or am I wrong? I kind of tried to figure this out one time, though, you know, I'm like, wait a minute. Bunnies don't lay eggs. What is this all about? Where do these things come from? Actually, it's, again, this time of year, as a culture, we kind of said, well, it's kind of about spring and things coming back to life, right? And as things come back to life, you think about what's very prolific? Bunnies. Okay? What else is very prolific? The birds like to make a lot of little babies, right? So there's eggs up there. So they kind of took those two things and they mashed them together. All right, not a bad thing. A little confusing as you're growing up. Maybe you're looking at going, what is this all about? But what I've always thought was interesting is, as a general idea, to have that as a something that we work with is good. But then sometimes I think it finds its way into true thoughts, like the church, like the Bible. And that's when it starts to get a little bit off, because if you start to think about it, like, okay, why this time of year do we start to talk about Jesus rising from the dead, right? Because isn't that what this day is about, to those who believe? This is a special day where we remember and we think about the fact that Jesus rose from the dead. Now, why is that? Compared with bunnies and eggs and all those kind of things. Why is it this time of year? And why? Here's an interesting thing. I never really even thought about it until I started doing this. Why do we call it Easter? Right? Why do we call it Easter? Easter has nothing to do with Jesus rising from the dead. As a matter of fact, if I started looking for it, the word Easter, it really wasn't anywhere, but I believe that it was based back, way back, when people of old, again, in those olden times, were looking for these significant events for them to be able to attach to. And so they started to look at this time of year, and they had this celebration, and it was connected with, if you put that first one up, Joe, Easter had to do with a pagan tradition, okay? And the pagan tradition was based in this goddess named E-O-S-T-E-R. Instead of Easter, it's E-O-S-T-E-R. That's what the goddess name was. Now, the reason I think that it was kind of matched with that, and it makes a lot of sense that it would, because guess what her title, what she was about? The Teutonic goddess of rising light of day and spring. Now, does that make sense when we start to look at bunny eggs and, you know, all these things that we talk about? That things are starting to come to life. And so the word Easter is literally from this goddess, E-O-S-T-E-R, I don't know how to pronounce that. And this is what she was about. And so this time of year already had a celebration going on. Now, how did we get to the church focusing on Jesus rising from the dead? Well, there's a couple of things. First of all, the church sees something like this already going on. The people are already celebrating it as a group. And so what do? Rather than make our own holiday and try and make it catch on, we'll attach ourselves to something that already exists. Does that make sense? Kind of a smart thing to do. Only problem with it is that as you put the two together, things can start to get confusing, especially if we're trying to talk about the truth and not just